Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Savijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 24th of March. India-Pakistan hold talks on Indus River water sharing after 2 years. Stance on resignations unchanged, says Pakistan People's Party. And NATO sees no easy solution in Afghanistan, says Stoltenberg. And now for all the details. India and Pakistan on Wednesday held their first meeting after 2019 of a commission on water rights from the Indus River in a further sign of rapprochement in relations frozen over Kashmir disputes. The meeting that began on Tuesday resumed on its second day in Indian capital New Delhi on Wednesday. India and Pakistan on Wednesday held their first meeting since 2019 of a commission that deals with water rights on the Indus River, illustrating a broader resumption of diplomatic ties. The meeting that began on Tuesday resumed on its second day in Indian capital New Delhi on Wednesday. Pakistan is concerned that India's plans for hydroelectric plants in its Kashmir Valley will damage the flow of Indus River, which feeds 80% of its irrigated agriculture along with tributaries. India has defended the construction of its Pakal Dul and Lower Kalnai dams, saying they are allowed by the Indus Water Treaty brokered by the World Bank. The talks are the latest in both countries' efforts to re-engage after a 2019 suicide bomb attack in India's Jammu and Kashmir that New Delhi blamed on Pakistan-based terrorists, and India's decision later in the year to strip the special status of its Jammu and Kashmir state. The Indus River use talks follow a rare joint ceasefire agreement between militaries of India and Pakistan along their de facto border in Kashmir, which exchanged fire hundreds of times in recent months. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday addressed public rallies to campaign for his ruling Bharatiya Janata Party in poll-bound states of West Bengal and Assam. While the BJP seeks to put an end to the 10-year rule of Trinamool Congress in Bengal, it is campaigning to retain power in northeastern Assam state.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday addressed massive public rallies to campaign for his ruling BJP, the Bharatiya Janata Party, in poll-bound states of West Bengal and Assam. Speaking in West Bengal's East Midnapur, PM Modi hit out at the Trinamool Congress, which rules the state, for rising corruption and ignoring development. As he said, it is BJP's promise and resolve to bring progress if voted to power. While the BJP seeks to put an end to the 10-year rule of the Trinamool Congress in West Bengal, it is campaigning to retain power in Assam, where polls will be held from March 27 to April 6. In his rally in Assam, Modi said under BJP's rule there has been vast development in the northeastern state as compared to under previous regime of Congress.
Bengal ka vikas, yahan ke logo ka vikas, ye BJP ka commitment hai. Ye BJP ka sankalp hai.
Meanwhile, West Bengal's Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee also held a public meeting to campaign for Trinamool Congress, where she blamed BJP leaders arrive from outside ahead of elections but remain absent during crisis. The election to the 294-seat West Bengal Assembly will be held between March 27 and April 29 in 8 phases. The results for both Assam and West Bengal will be announced on 2nd of May.
In news from Pakistan, the Pakistan People's Party has said that its stance on the issue of resignations of lawmakers was still unchanged, as it backs the idea of resigning from the assemblies, but at an appropriate time. The reluctance by Pakistan People's Party has forced 10-party opposition alliance PDM to postpone the long march against the incumbent government scheduled for March 26.
Pakistan People's Party Central Punjab President Qamar Zaman Khyra on Tuesday said the party's stance on the issue of resignations of lawmakers was still unchanged as it believed in a joint struggle and backed the idea of resigning from the assemblies but at an appropriate time. Khyra said that his party never wanted any cracks in the opposition alliance Pakistan Democratic Movement and would hold negotiations with PDM leadership after a meeting of the PPP's Central Executive Committee on April 4.
हाँ, हम ये कहते हैं कि जो आप कुछ पॉइंट छोड़ के कुछ स्टेप छोड़ के आगे जाने की बात कर रहे हैं और आप अगली स्टेप पे पहुंच रहे हैं उसके लिए हमारे ख्याल में हो सकता है हमारे दोस्त दुरुस्त हो, हो सकता है हम दुरुस्त हो लेकिन हमारी दानिश में उसके लिए वक्त मुनासिब नहीं।
Pakistan Democratic Movement, the 10-party opposition alliance, appeared to be in tatters last week because of serious differences on the issue of resignations, which it believes has become indispensable for launching a decisive political movement to oust Prime Minister Imran Khan. The issue also forced it to postpone the scheduled long march against the government on March 26.
Moving on, scores of doctors recently held a protest outside the secretariat office in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan to demand job regularization. Highlighting exploitation, they blame the authorities have kept on delaying the process for the past several years.
Scores of doctors in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan recently staged a demonstration outside the secretariat office to demand job regularization, which is being denied to them. The protesters said their contractual status has not been upgraded, even after almost 1 year of the ratification of an act ensuring them a better salary and permanent status, and the Pakistani government has kept pushing the issue into bureaucratic hassles. They also lamented ignorance towards building government institutes offering postgraduate medical studies for young doctors in the region.
कॉन्ट्रैक्ट रेगुलराइजेशन का जो एक्ट पास हुआ था 2020 में उस पर अभी तक जो है ना दस्तखत नहीं किया गया और पिछले 9 माह से जो है हमें जो है वेट कराया जा रहा है इसका वजह भी हमें नहीं बताया जा रहा कि क्यों कर रहे हैं लेकिन बहुत सालों से जो है ना डॉक्टर्स काम कर रहे हैं और वो रेगुलर नहीं हो रहे
हमारे इस वक्त गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान के 40 से 50 डॉक्टर इस तरह हैं जिन्होंने एफसीपीएस पार्ट 1 डिफरेंट स्पेशलिटी में पास करके बैठे हुए हैं वो दर बदर के ठोकरे खा रहे हैं कहीं पे भी उनकी सुनवाई नहीं हो रही है उसकी सबसे बड़ी वजह यह है कि गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान में टर्शियरी हॉस्पिटल
Locals and government workers in Gilgit-Baltistan have to often hit the streets to demand even their basic rights. The doctors in the illegally occupied region had to also hold massive protests last year as they lacked even masks and PPE kits amid surging COVID-19 cases.
NATO Chief Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg has said the alliance sees there is no easy solution in Afghanistan and that a negotiated solution is the only way to achieve a sustainable peace in the war-torn country. The remarks came after a meeting of NATO's foreign ministers in Brussels on Tuesday, where the ministers emphasized their full support to all efforts to reinvigorate the Afghan peace process.
NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg, following the NATO ministerial meeting in Brussels on Tuesday, said that the alliance sees that there is no easy solution in Afghanistan. Stoltenberg made the comments after the meeting of NATO's foreign ministers in Brussels on Tuesday, where the ministers emphasized their full support to all efforts to reinvigorate the Afghan peace process. This comes as the NATO military alliance is yet to announce plans on any possible troop withdrawal from Afghanistan as per the US-Taliban agreement signed last year.
We all see that there is no easy solution. There is no risk-free path ahead, and we need to prepare for all options. Ministers emphasized their full support to all efforts to reinvigorate the peace process, because a negotiated solution is the only way to achieve a sustainable peace, which prevents Afghanistan from again becoming a platform for international terrorism.
At NATO foreign ministers' meeting in Brussels on Tuesday, German Foreign Minister Heiko Maas also warned against a premature pullout that would see gains in security, education, infrastructure and human rights quickly lost.
In news from Sri Lanka, Sri Lanka on Tuesday claimed victory at the UNHRC, saying a majority of the members have not voted in favor of a resolution calling for accountability for human rights violations in the final phase of the war against the Tamil Tiger rebels. The island nation's foreign minister Dinesh Gunawardena said the resolution lacked authority as more nations voted against or abstained than in favor.
Sri Lanka claimed victory at the United Nations Human Rights Commission on Tuesday, saying a majority of the members have not voted in favor of a resolution calling for the accountability for human rights violations in the final phase of the war against the Tamil Tiger rebels. At a news conference in Sri Lanka's capital Colombo, Foreign Minister Dinesh Gunawardena said the resolution lacked authority as more nations voted against or abstained than in favor. The vote was 22 in favor, with 11 against, including China and Pakistan, and 14 abstentions, including neighboring India.
They want to have a special process against Sri Lanka to collect various information. This is what this resolution initiates, but leading to much more dangerous objectives if they were able to succeed. Out of the 47 countries of the Human Rights Commission, they could harness only 22. 25 votes was not on their side of the resolution. They did not say yes to the resolution. This is the most important message that the countries in Geneva has given amidst great pressure by the European countries on them.
The United Nations believe 80,000 to 100,000 people died in the 26-year conflict in which the rebels sought to carve out a separate state for the Tamil minority in Sri Lanka.
Moving on to news from Bangladesh. Bangladesh's largest annual book fair has kicked off in capital Dhaka, bringing 540 organizations to display their literature. The main theme of this year's fair is the birth centenary of Father of the Nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, and the Golden Jubilee of the country's independence.
Bangladesh's largest annual book fair has kicked off in capital Dhaka, bringing together books, readers and writers to celebrate literature. Hundreds of stalls have been allocated to 540 organizations this year at the event, which is being held at Dhaka's Bangla Academy premises. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic this year, the month-long book fair was moved to March 18 instead of its scheduled yearly beginning date, February 1. The main theme of the fair this time is the birth centenary of Father of the Nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, and the Golden Jubilee of the country's independence. The fair will conclude on April 14.
Artists and art lovers are rejoicing in India's northern hill town of Shimla as a famous heritage theatre has reopened after being closed for almost 1 year due to coronavirus restrictions. The curtain raiser event witnessed traditional dance and music of Himachal Pradesh state.
Artist and art lovers rejoiced in India's northern hill town of Shimla as a famous heritage theatre held a curtain raiser event after almost 1 year of coronavirus lockdown earlier this week. Shimla's more than 100-year-old Gothic-style Gaiety Theatre reopened on Monday, where artists presented traditional dance and music of Himachal Pradesh state. The performers said they were happy and relieved that the theatres were opening again as they suffered huge economic losses due to the lockdown.
पहले तो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है कि एक साल बाद जो ये प्रोग्राम हो रहे हैं और आप सबको जैसे पता है कोरोना के चलते हुए एक साल तक कोई भी प्रोग्राम नहीं हुआ है जिससे कि कलाकारों को बहुत से मतलब नुकसान हुए हैं क्योंकि एक साल से कला को कोई भी प्रोग्राम्स नहीं मिले हैं तो हम तो यही चाहते हैं कि ऐसे प्रोग्राम होते रहे.
Public places across India, including cinemas, theatres and shopping malls, were shut after the Indian government declared a nationwide lockdown in March last year due to the coronavirus pandemic.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.